Sri Sukhendu Sekhar Roy.
Thank you, sir. Sir, the citizens of the country are deeply concerned with the economic situation prevailing now, because in every sector, in every field of economy, the government has failed miserably. Why I am saying so? Because with the introduction of this demonetization, which according to the Supreme Court, it was carpet bombing on the citizens. And secondly, the mismanagement of the GST. This double shock has created this situation. If we go through the figures quickly, first of all, this GDP growth, many members have said, I remember that when we were discussing demonetization issue, Dr. Manmohan Singh, in this house, he was on record saying that according to his estimates, there will be 2% decline, about 2% decline in the GDP growth. Now everybody is saying that the GDP growth will be declined and already declined. Compared to 8% in 2015-16, it came down to 7.1% in 2016-17. And now the SBI research chief economist, he says that it is, I quote, it is difficult for GDP to cross 7% this fiscal. Similarly, other people have said. Now, sir, if we look at the industrial growth, the investment rate, this is gross fixed capital formation. The investment rate measured as the ratio of the gross fixed capital formation to GDP at current prices was further down to 26.9% from 28.1%, indicating that corporates have not been investing in capital creation. This is a major area of concern. Second, the industrial growth. Manufacturing and electricity sector output is lower compared to previous years. The use-based classification reveals that barring non-durable consumer goods, all other sectors witnessed lower growth rates. And the forecast is that industrial growth for the year is only 4 to 4.5%. Agriculture, the major area, India live in villages, it was said by Gandhiji. The agriculture, the farmers are not getting remunerative prices. They have adopted self. Because nachar hai kisan, usko dam nahi mil raha hai. Aatmahatya kar rahi hai Maharashtra mein, dusri jagah mein, sare Hindustan mein. Halaki BJP ka jo manifesto, shayad Maniya Amit Shah ji ne wo manifesto release kiya tha, mujhe malum nahi, subject to correction. Wo manifesto ka page 19 mein bataya gaya tha ki cost of production se dugura hum इंश्योर करेंगे प्राइस किसानों को. अभी तक हुआ नहीं, कुछ नहीं हुआ, आत्महत्या बढ़ते जा रही है. सर, गवर्नमेंट फाइनेंसेस एज पर द लेटेस्ट डाटा रिलीज बाय द गवर्नमेंट फॉर द पीरियड अप्रैल टू नवंबर 2017, द फिस्कल डेफिसिट इज 112% ऑफ द टारगेट, व्हाइल द रेवेन्यू डेफिसिट इज 152.2% of the budgeted amount. This has prompted the government to announce an additional borrowing program of rupees 50,000 crore for the year. Yes. So the fiscal deficit number would go up to 3.5% of GDP for the financial year 2018, estimated by some experts. I am not an expert, but this is the view of the experts. So far the banking sector is concerned, we have talked about, we have discussed at length, I need not repeat. But the credit growth to manufacturing and services for April-October negative, while that to agriculture and personal loan segment is 7.7%. External sector, while growth in export was at 12% for the period April to November 2017, a little better than the earlier time, imports too surged by 21.9%, leading to a higher trade deficit of $100 billion compared to $68 billion last year. From $68 billion to $100 billion deficit of trade deficit. So now, yes, the foreign direct investment has increased. Foreign direct investment, no doubt, has increased. But how much? It has created jobs in the country. I have every doubt. Because the country has been dragged through 10 years of jobless growth, no doubt. This is why BJP manifesto again promised to the nation that under the broader economic revival, BJP will accord high priority job to creation and opportunities for entrepreneurship. Honorable Pradhan Mantri Ji bhi Agra mein aam sabha sambodhit karte hue unhone bola tha aur dusri jagah bhi bola tha ki hum har saal 1 crore hum job create karenge 2 crore subject to karenge 2 crore aam sabha sambodhit karte deshen ko bataya gaya tha unke man mein pratyasha tha main unko dosh nahi de raha hu bhai wo charcha kar raha hu jo unhone bola tha. अभी देखिए क्या हाल है. पहला तीन साल में बीजेपी सत्ता में आने के बाद पहला तीन साल में 2.47 मिलियन से घटके 1.51 मिलियन हो गया जॉब. कितना बेरोजगारी बढ़ गई. अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट सिचुएशन दे कुड नॉट क्रिएट इट वॉज लेसनिंग अकॉर्डिंग टू ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ इकोनॉमिक कॉरपोरेशन एंड डेवलपमेंट रिपोर्ट पब्लिश इन 2017. Rate of employment has declined and job creation has not kept up with the growing market age population, working age population. What is that? More than 30% of Indians, more than 30% of the Indians aged between 15 to 29 years are neither in employment nor in education and training. Aapne skill development, startup, बहुत सारे स्कीम लाया. मैं इसको विरोध हम विरोध नहीं करते हैं. लेकिन इसके बावजूद भी ये युवाओं का देश है और इस देश के युवाओं का हाल क्या है कि 30% बिटवीन द एज ग्रुप ऑफ 15 टू 29 दे आर नॉट इन एम्प्लॉयमेंट नो हेयर दे डू नॉट हैव एनी जॉब्स. अगर ये हाल है हमारे देश की युवाओं की तो अब हम जब गर्व से कहते हैं कि युवाओं का देश है वो आगे बढ़ेंगे कैसे आगे बढ़ेंगे. Sir, now I'd like to conclude because my time is running out, although I found from there that 8 minutes has been allotted to me. Now it has been reduced for so many reasons, I don't know.
Please.
Last point. मैंने हमेशा बोला हमारा पार्टी मांग कर रहे कि पानामा पेपर्स जो निकाला था उसका बाद जो पैराडाइज पेपर्स आया पैराडाइज पेपर में पानामा पेपर में 500 से अधिक इंडियन का नाम निकाला था. वो इलीगल था कि लीगल था हम नहीं जानते. सरकार जांच करे. क्या जांच किया 3 साल में मुझे मालूम नहीं. इस बीच में पैराडाइज पेपर आ गया उसमें और 700 इंडियन का नाम जो हो गया जो ऑफशोर इलीगल ट्रेडिंग या सीक्रेट डीलिंग किया वो फर्जी कंपनी बना के. तो ये सारे चीज हम चाहते हैं कि सामने आए सरकार बताए कि इसमें कौन कौन लोग इन्वॉल्व है. एंड द लास्ट पॉइंट हमने जो बोला था पहले बोला था कि ये सुपर इमरजेंसी लाइक सिचुएशन पैदा हो गया देश में. इतना बड़ा खतरा पैदा हो गया कि बैंकों को बैंक में पैसा रखना सही होगा कि नहीं होगा. अब सारे देश की जनता चिंतित है. ये बिल ला रहा है सरकार. अब इंसॉल्वेंसी बैंक्रप्सी कोर्ट बनाएगा उसमें बैंक को भी इंसॉल्वेंट और बैंक्रप्ट डिक्लेयर किया जाएगा कि नहीं जाएगा. ऐसा एक माहौल पैदा हो गया. इसलिए आपके माध्यम से मेरे सरकार से निवेदन है कि ब्लैक मनी के ऊपर व्हाइट पेपर निकाले जैसे कि डॉक्टर मनमोहन सिंह सरकार ने निकाला था. उसके बाद क्या हुआ 3-4 साल में वो हम जानना चाहते हैं. धन्यवाद.
धन्यवाद.